Well, hello friends and followers. It's been a long time since I last made a video to share with y'all. Wondered where we're at today. We're in Breezewood, Pennsylvania, and we're about to explore the abandoned Pennsylvania Turnpike, including a 3,500 foot long tunnel that's open for bicycle travel. This is something that's been on my bucket list for a long, long time, ever since I found out about it. I remember going through these tunnels on a family vacation back in the early 60s. And now it's going to be my opportunity to pedal through on a bicycle. So hop on aboard and let's go. All right, I hope I have my camera aimed well enough so you can see the action here and you can hear me too. We're actually riding on the eastbound lanes of the old Pennsylvania Turnpike. Over here to the side, you can barely see it there. It's all overgrown. That's the old westbound lane over there. I think this was abandoned in the mid-60s. They decided that the tunnel was too much of an impediment to traffic. Traffic volumes were too high, and it was going to cost too much money to add more capacity to the tunnel, so they decided just to go up and over the hill here. And when they were all done, they just abandoned the turnpike and let it sit for a while. For a while, it stayed in the possession of the Pennsylvania Turnpike Commission. But eventually, they sold it to a conservancy whose intention was to convert it into a bicycle trail. And that plan seems to have stalled. But it is open and available for cycling. It's just not maintained. Hello. Today it's about noon on Sunday, and there were at least half a dozen other vehicles, if not more, down there at the trailhead. So I expect to see lots of folks along the trail here today, and especially once we get up to the tunnel. It's only about maybe a half a mile up here. The tunnel goes through a ridge in the Alleghenies called Ray's Hill. Runs pretty much north to south here, and the tunnel itself is about 3,600 feet long. That's almost 3/4 of a mile. I don't know what to expect when we get up there. I have my bike fitted with special tubes, slime tubes. They're supposed to be anti-flat. If you get a puncture in your tube, it'll seal right up and you won't lose too much air. So I'm hoping. I hear there's supposed to be a lot of trash and puncture dangers along this road. For a while this section remained in the possession of the Turnpike Commission, they used it to test. I've read stuff where they actually tested and developed those reflective lane markers that you see everywhere now that are actually set into the concrete. I've seen pictures someplace up ahead here where they're still in the pavement and you can actually see where they installed them and were testing. This way to hell, turn back, it said on the pavement there. I'm not sure it's that scary. So here comes a father with two kids. Hello.
Hello, how you doing?
Good. It looked like they escaped damnation in hell. Really doesn't look like anyone's made any attempt at all to beat back nature here. Although I would expect after a quarter of a century more of abandonment that this road should be barely visible. There shouldn't be anything left here. So maybe they have made some attempt to trim it in the past. The house and the farm over there. Boy, back in the day, the turnpike zoomed right past that place. Wonder how they liked that. Now here's a spot, it looks like they were practicing a different pavement, and right here you see in the pavement these set-in reflectors. Pioneer developed on the Pennsylvania Turnpike. You can see other things they were experimenting here with, these grooves. Grooves in the pavement. Probably they were going to lay some kind of reflective material in there or something. Or maybe just practicing techniques. Here are two side by side different examples. They probably did tests, compared the reflectivity, so forth from a distance. Series of four of them in a row here. Can definitely tell this was their test pad. Run now. Oh, come now. I don't think so. You okay?
Yep. We're waiting on all the people.
Okay.
A little ways ahead of them.
And there we get our first glimpse of the tunnel. Rays Hill Tunnel. View of the countryside here. Off in the distance there, the Laurel Highlands, Pennsylvania. This is a little bridge here. Turnpike used to go over a little two-lane country road here. It's a good thing they didn't tear the bridge out. It still remains. This is called Mountain Chapel Road, I think. All right, let's go. Tunnel time. Some problems with my bike right now, too. The brakes are dragging really bad. The bike was riding fine at home when I test rode it, and I drove 400 miles here, pulled it off the rack, and the rear tire didn't want to turn. I have no idea what that's about. Makes it a little bit hard. This looks pretty creepy, and looks quite a bit post-apocalyptic, if you ask me. So here we are, entrance to the tunnel. Not nearly as dark inside as I thought it would be. And you can actually see the light at the far end, which I was not expecting. That's over almost 3/4 of a mile away. Not as dark at all. In fact, I might not even need my lights in here. No sign of deterioration, no ceiling crumbling. Just a lot of dirt and graffiti. This is the entrance here to the old ventilation works, and for a long time it was open. You could go in there. It was pretty dangerous in there, so they've welded bars across the door. You can't get in anymore. I've seen lots of videos on YouTube of people up in there exploring, and you can actually go up to the top there. A bank of windows up there. You could go up to the top and look out, probably come out the other side and back down. I like how the vines growing up the tunnel now. Turn on my light and see what we can see in here. Debris, destruction. God knows what debaucheries this room has seen. Old couch and chair here. Ugh, looks like actually van seats. All right, I'm gonna try to do a selfie here. I don't know how good this is working or not. I'm holding my helmet. My camera's attached to the helmet. It's probably shaking like crazy right now. Here I am. I finally made it. Standing in front of Ray's Hill Tunnel. Breezewood, Pennsylvania, abandoned Pennsylvania Turnpike. Long ago, on that concrete facing up there, there was a sign, metal letters that spelled out Ray's Hill Tunnel. And that's long since disappeared. It's probably in somebody's man cave now, or gathering dust in an old garage. No trespassing. Violators will be prosecuted. All right, now the fun part. This is what we came for. The ride through the tunnel. Quick check here to make sure we're filming. Yes, indeed. Here we go into the tunnel. Sure hope this turns out. Go down here a little ways. so we can get a nice approach shot. Rays Hill Tunnel in 3, 2, 1. Wow, amazing. I bought these 290 lumen flashlights. I figured they'd light this tunnel up like nobody's business. And they barely illuminate anything. The light is just like absorbed. I don't know if you can see anything. I have one on my helmet, one on the handlebars, two on the fork. They're little wimpy ones to light the front wheel. Waka waka! Some real artists in here. Old electrical box. Sex was made here, I'm sure, many times. Careful. The old reflectors are still in place here. Hey, my initials. Blue Bloods and Red Crips, okay. I need to walk through here with a big light, film all this graffiti. This is amazing. It's cool in here. There's no dripping water. Nothing like that. A few places where it's seeping, maybe. I mean, you could come through here, power wash this dude, and be driving cars through it in a week. Look at there. We're halfway through already. Stop in the middle. Light at one end, light at the other end. We're not quite halfway. Cool, some real artists in here. Fago! I'm gonna crash staring at these walls. I spent $40, $45 on flashlights to light up this tunnel. I might as well have used a candle. Wow. Good thing it's not night. This would really be something at night. They should do a Halloween haunted house in here. So in the midst of all this negative graffiti and nasty dirtiness written on the walls, and I'm wondering if anyone ever writes anything nice on the walls. There you go. Love is always the brightest light. That had to have been a girl that wrote that. Cool. definitely need to come back and hike through here on foot. Middle of tunnel, right here it says. You were here. West, east, up, down. Redneck Barbie. Oh, I bet she's quite a girl. So just for kicks, let's see how bad it is without our lights. Goes the handlebar light off. Helmet light off. Fork lights off. Ooh, scary. Wow, I don't know if I can ride in this. My whistle doesn't work either. Die in about 2 minutes if I try to ride in the dark. I'm gonna ride just a little ways. I might pedal right smack into the wall. If I keep that light right focused on that, I should be able to do it. As long as there's nothing in the road that's gonna flatten me or tip me over. This would be badass on a dirt bike. What? All right, here we come. A couple hundred yards yet. Distances are so deceiving. Was badass. I thought I saw you yesterday, but I knew it wasn't you. Whatever, huh? What? All right, emerging the eastern portal, Rays Hill Tunnel. Pretty cool. I bet that's really pretty in the fall. That whole hillside, orange and red and yellow. Not too much interesting at this end. Got pigeons going up in there. I hear water running. The old drainage is still working. Wow, those pigeons make a weird noise. See what's in here. Dead bodies, it says. I wouldn't doubt it. Ghastly. Satan's torture chamber. Wonder how much crack has been smoked in here. Now it's really cool. I wasn't sure I'd want to do it or not, but now that I'm here, why the hell not? A couple miles up ahead, there's another tunnel called the Sidling Hill Tunnel. And it's even longer than the one we just came through, so what the hell? Let's go.